up tonight. So before we begin, I'd just like to say, if anyone, for all those who are speaking tonight, if you could come up here and just hang out back here, it'll make the night a lot easier. To give you a quick rundown how this evening is going to go, we're going to have a few students and Jewish communal leaders speak. We're going to recite some prayers and first and foremost we're gonna stand together united, because if there's one thing we can do, it's that we can stand united. Can you guys hear in the back or no?
Turn it off, Ethan.
Hey! You have to like speak louder.
Can you hear now?
I got it.
We'll be loud. You gotta be way loud.
I'm Yisrael Chai!
Come on, everyone, let me hear it a little louder. I'm Yisrael Chai!
I'm Yisrael Chai!
One more time, a little louder. Together, 1, 2, 3.
I'm Yisrael Chai!
I'm Yisrael Chai.
I'm Yisrael Chai. I'm Yisrael. I'm Yisrael. I'm Yisrael Chai. I'm Yisrael Chai. I'm Yisrael Chai.
Ariel, do you want to come up and lead us in a prayer for Israel?
Yeah. When Jewish people are in a time of distress, in a time of need, throughout the ages, we turn to the one in heaven to arouse his mercy upon the Jewish people and the world. Ariel, please lead us in the Tehillim, first in Hebrew, and then everyone together in English.
Shir lama'alat esa enai el ha'arim ma'ayin yavo ezri. Ezri mehem Adonai asa shamayim va'aretz. Al yiten lamot raglecha, al inom shomrecha. Ine lo inom velo ishan shomer Yisrael. Adonai shomrecha, Adonai tzilecha, al yad yaminecha. Yomam ha'shemesh lo yekake ve'arech balayla. Adonai ishmarach mekol hara, ishmor et nafshecha. Adonai ishmor tzatecha uvoecha me'ata ve'ad olam. A song for ascents. I shall raise my eyes to the mountains. From where will my help come? My help is from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to falter. Your guardian will not slumber. Behold, the guardian of Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your guardian. The Lord is your shadow. He is by your right hand. By day, the sun will not smite you, nor will the moon at night. The Lord will guard you from all evil. He will guard your soul. The Lord will guard your going out and your coming in from now and to eternity.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ethan Fine, and I'm a junior here. And I'm the president of IPAC, one of our pro-Israel groups.
One of our pro-Israel groups on campus. And I'm incredibly proud to be one of the organizers of this incredible event.
Give it up for Ethan!
During this unimaginably difficult time, it brings joy to me and to all of you that there are so many familiar faces, but it brings even more joy to me that there are so many unfamiliar faces. Before I begin, I'd like to take a short moment of silence for all the Israeli civilians who have been brutally murdered and kidnapped. And I'd also like to take this moment to ask you to pray for the men and women of Israel who are no older than you and I, who are risking their lives to defend the state of Israel. Tonight we gather in immense sorrow, in immense pain, and in immense anger. For many of us, this has been a sleepless weekend, constantly refreshing social media, frantically texting and calling loved ones in Israel, and trying to understand how any human being is capable of what we saw and heard. Never in our lifetime have the Jewish people witnessed a tragedy like this. There have been rockets and stabbings and shootings and incendiary balloons and kidnappings all throughout our lives. There were operations and battles against Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihad in Gaza, where dozens of our brothers and sisters, who unfortunately made the ultimate sacrifice and died al Kiddush Hashem while defending the people and land of Israel. This weekend, we joined our parents and grandparents in understanding something that we were fortunate enough to never know. Stories were etched into the minds of each of us as kids, from our parents and grandparents, our rabbis and educators, retelling the experiences in both Israel and America during the Six-Day War, the Yom Kippur War, the Lebanon Wars, the Intifadas, and more. But never could any of us imagine we would face a day as bloody as we did on Saturday. Over 1,000 were murdered. Over 130 were taken as hostages. Women and girls were brutally beaten and raped. Over 250 civilians were murdered at a music festival. If that happened in America, it would be the worst mass shooting in our history, more than 20 times deadlier than the Columbine shooting. Bodies of over 100 people from a single village were discovered today. Dead bodies were paraded through the streets of Gaza. Israeli children were put in cages. Hostages were beaten and dragged through the streets. There is no both sides. There is no justification. There is no defending of terrorism or the cruelty that we witnessed this weekend. There can only be a swift and unequivocal condemnation of Hamas, of Palestinian Islamic Jihad, of Iran, and of evil. Just as our grandparents and great-grandparents went door to door in their cities, raising money for JNF with those little blue tzedakah boxes that we all grew up with to build our nation in the 1940s. Just as our parents raised money for Israel after the Six-Day War, after the Lebanon Wars, after the Yom Kippur Wars, and after the Intifadas, so must we all. Kol Yisrael Aravim Zebazet. All of Israel is responsible for each other. So must we answer the call that our parents and grandparents answered decades ago. We must unite as one community as we have tonight and raise money and organize supplies for our brothers and sisters in Israel who desperately need our help. We must continue to support the brave men and women who risk their lives every day to protect, defend, and save the land, the people, and the state of Israel. From the soldiers who are no older than you and I, to the brave paramedics and volunteers with Magen David Adom and Hatzalah, to the women and children collecting food and supplies while their husbands, fathers, and sons are protecting our country that we love. They need our help, now more than ever. We must unite and pool our resources. Together we can make a difference from here in Bloomington. This is a call that we must answer. We also must unite as a community in Bloomington. For all of us, this is personal. The pain we have experienced is unimaginable. Like many of you, my friends and family spent this weekend in bomb shelters. These past few nights have been sleepless, as it has been for many of us, as we waited for texts and calls from our friends and loved ones. And so many of us are still waiting for those calls. My friends are gearing up across southern and northern Lebanon, or northern Israel, to defend our homeland and to bring our brothers and sisters home. Your friends are, your family are, and we must stay united. Now more than ever, we need each other. We have to unite as a community. Check in on your friends.
Go out of your way to be kind. We will only get through this together. It's also important that I sound the alarm for what is to be expected here in America over the next coming days, weeks, and months. A wave of unprecedented anti-Semitism will come, just as it did in May of 2021. As supporters of Israel have gathered across the country, so too have those who seek our destruction. Anti-Semitic protesters have cheered for the lives lost. They've waved swastikas in the streets of America, and they've called for the destruction of Israel. They want more deaths, and they've called and celebrated for the deaths of hundreds of civilians. In May of 2021, when Israel defended itself from an unforeseen barrage of rockets, students on college campuses across the country were subjected to a scary rise in anti-Semitism. The fake news and the propaganda we were subjected to will not change. Worst of all, people you thought were your friends will cheer and excuse the death of your friends and family. People you have known your whole life will reveal their true selves to you. This is why it is of utmost importance to continue spreading the truth. We must continue defending Israel on social media, in the classroom, and on campus, and wherever we are. Millions of Americans have gathered or will have gathered by the end of this week with their communities, just as we do tonight. We have gathered not only to mourn the loss of our brothers and sisters in Eretz Israel, but we have gathered to celebrate our love of Israel, our community, and we will celebrate the fact that we will never let terror win! We will never let Hamas or those who seek our destruction to intimidate us. We will never stop. We will never stop loving Israel and supporting Israel and standing together united. Because when we are united, it is impossible to defeat us. There will be no shortage of difficult days ahead. But with the strength of this community, with the strength of Am Yisrael, we will get through this. We will be stronger. We will be more united than ever. And we will be more determined to do everything we can in our power to protect our homeland. I am in awe of the amount of people who are here. This is the largest gathering of Jewish or pro-Israel students in the history of the school. Thank you for coming. Our brothers and sisters in Israel see this. They will see this. And they will know that America has their back. That Burlington, the city of Burlington, Indiana has their back. And we will send a message to elected officials across the state and across the country that America has Israel's back and that this is the fight that we are in together. Now let's say it with me, please, on the count of three, Am Yisrael Chai. One, two, three.
Am Yisrael Chai!
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm Rabbi Sue from Hillel, one of the Jewish student centers on campus.
Yes, Sue.
Woo.
Let's go!
Yeah. Rabbi Sue! Woo! Let's go.
I hear around us, we might want to try to ignore it, but when we hear people around us who call out for our destruction, what are we going to do? We're going to say we're going to be louder, and we're going to be prouder, because that's what we have to do when cowards try to take us down. We have to be prouder. So let's all together one more time as loud as you possibly can. Am Yisrael Chai!
Am Yisrael Chai!
Welcome to all of you. I'm absolutely overwhelmed to see so many people here tonight. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. We're here together in fear, sadness, vulnerability, pain, and anger. Anger that, again, the Jewish people, there are those that are out to destroy us, and we will not let them. Our gathering and it gives us the opportunity to come together as a community in support and caring and to show our love and our support for Israel. This summer I was in Israel 2 times, and when I'm in Israel, ironically, it's the only time that I feel completely safe as a Jew. During the second trip to Israel, we had a speaker who explained something that I hadn't thought about in a long time. He stated that as an Israeli Jew, he has nowhere else to go. Jews in Israel are living in our homeland and see Israel as deeply tied to our Jewish identity. We as Jews have no other homeland. We don't have anywhere else to go, as we were reminded shortly before the Holocaust began with the Evian Conference, when every country in the world was invited to take Jews in and every country refused, and there was no Israel then. So we have to have Israel as our homeland. Israel was reinstated as a Jewish state in 1948 after almost 2,000 years of exile from the land that we yearned for and lived in from 1400 BCE in the time of the Bible until 70 CE. In every Jewish prayer service for at least 2,000 years, we've faced Jerusalem, we've prayed for peace, and we've prayed to return to our homeland, Israel. And finally, in 1948, we were returned. I actually remember a long time ago, showing my age now, I was sitting in synagogue as a child when the Yom Kippur War broke out in 1973. And I'll never forget the terror that I felt when our rabbis stopped the service to tell us that Israel had been attacked. And that's the same fear, anger, and terror that I felt on Saturday when I heard about this, that again we're being attacked. All too often over the years when people speak about the numerous terror attacks in Israel and the battle going on for the safety and security of Israel, they speak about the conflict. What is happening in Israel is not a conflict. A conflict is an argument, a disagreement, a clash. What is happening in Israel today is brutal war that has been waged on our homeland of Israel by a recognized terrorist organization, by Hamas. They have launched an unprecedented attack against Israel. The large-scale surprise attack by Gaza militants on Israel on Saturday has left over 1,000 Israelis dead, innocent children, infants, teens, women, and men who've done nothing other than try to live in our homeland. And on Saturday, when many Israelis were likely to have been asleep, sirens were heard as far as Tel Aviv as rockets flew over Israel. There was a music festival in the south where they were celebrating Israeli music and culture, where they were deliberately and brutally attacked, and more than 260 innocent people were murdered. And today we've come together to mourn for those who've been killed, to cry out against terrorism, and to show our support and our love for Israel, and to pray for peace. That's what we want. We want to pray for peace and to show that we as Jews will always rise up. We will always pray for peace. Although all of us here tonight come from many different places and backgrounds, we all share one thing. My children's father lives in Israel, as do their grandparents, cousins, aunts, and uncle. And we each feel an almost indescribable connection to the land of Israel. Some of us here tonight have traveled in Israel. Some have lived in Israel. Some have been there on birthright trips. Some have done year abroad programs. Some of us have family living in Israel. Others of us have many friends there. And others think of our deep ties and connections with the Israelis that we've met and traveled with. And even for those of us who've never been there before, somehow we feel a deep connection and tie to Israel. One of our students here described it best when he said, "When I was a little boy, my father told me that there was a country for the Jewish people. And ever since that day, I knew that I had to go there." Every year during Passover, we recount the story of the Exodus from Egypt and how we were brought out of the land of Egypt and freed from slavery and began a period of wandering in the desert until ultimately we entered our promised land. Our home is a Jewish people, the land of Israel over 2,000 years ago. And now, over 2,000 years later, we still celebrate that journey to Israel and celebrate the modern state of Israel and our right and our responsibility to love and support our homeland. So once again, let us all say together, Am Yisrael Chai!
Am Yisrael Chai!
We will not stand idly by. We are proud and loud, and we are going to continue to be loud and proud. Noam and Tomer.
Hey, my name is Tomer. This is Noam. We're both from Israel. Hey, my name is Tomer, and this is Noam. We are both from Israel. We grew up in Israel, and we came here to the U.S. To accomplish some goals. My very best friends right now are fighting in Israel to save our land, and I'm kind of feeling stuck being here and useless that I cannot help them. There's nothing really we can do from here, but I just want to say that we are all grateful for you guys, that you're supporting us. And if there is one thing that we can do, it's just making the public more aware. So just keep sharing and keep telling your friends what it means to you. So thank you.
We also wanted to thank all of our friends back home that right now are taking care of each other in the most incredible way that you can see in any other place in the world. They're risking their life for strangers and for our home right now. And these people are the only reason that I, after the past 2.5 days and everything that's been going on, still believe that humans are good. And I just want to say my heart is with my country. And thank you all for being here tonight. It's really, it means a lot for everyone to see that the U.S. has our back.
Hi, I will try to keep this short because what I have to say is, you know, what most people have said. But I just want to say that in the past few days, I have been afraid of losing both friends in my home country of Israel, where I was born, and my friends in the States. In Israel, I have friends who I haven't heard from in days. I don't know how they're doing, whether they've been kidnapped, whether they're alive or dead. And in America, I've been losing friends because as I worry if my little sister or my grandmother will be the next ones taken, I see people who I considered friends rallying their support for the rapes, the beheadings, the murders, the kidnappings of innocent people. This is beyond politics. And this is beyond conflict. I have seen footage of the naked corpses of women being paraded through the streets, Facebook live streams of elderly Jews getting shot in the head, children being held hostage, crying for their mothers, pleading for their lives. And all of this is proudly and joyfully advertised on social media because the events of the past few days have not been for any cause except for killing civilians. I believe in the good of humanity, but by the hour it's getting more difficult. And I just wish that people would know that these are people. They're not the government. They're not a political ideal. They aren't statistics. They are people. My friends, my loved ones, my family. I have been a lifelong atheist, and I find myself praying every minute of every day that they're alive the next time I call them. Be human. To all of you that consider yourselves advocates for humanity, open your eyes and look at what is happening to people. The instant that you stop considering Jews as a part of humanity, you have lost the right to call yourself a human rights activist. And to those who want us dead, Jews have been hunted many, many times, and you've hurt us. But in the end, like always, you will fail. I will bet on the strength of our spirit over your hatred every single time. And to the rest of you, continue showing up for people. Keep fighting for innocent lives. And if you stand with humanity, you will stand with us today. Thank you.
Wow. The crowd over here, with every single one of you, with broken hearts and with hope, we all stand together in solidarity, in unity, with love and with peace, and we declare together, Am Yisrael Chai!
Am Yisrael Chai!
We declare it together! Jewish blood is not cheap!
Jewish blood is not cheap!
Throughout history, people thought that they will outlive the Jews, and those same people have rotted away. The people that are here, you know where Jews are not allowed? You know where we're not allowed in? We're not allowed into the museums. Because we're alive. Those anti-Semites are rotting in their graves. That's the only difference. We ask ourselves, how? How is it possible for such animalistic and demonic acts to be done to humanity, to be done to Jewish people? There's no answer. It is our duty to live proudly as Jews. It is our duty and our responsibility to keep on going, to keep Judaism alive. They use terror to scare us, and we will never, ever let them win. We are standing with broken hearts and with mixed feelings with everything that's happening. How can I go to class? How can I give my presentation when the only thing coming out of my mouth is crying? But we need to be happy, because happiness breaks all boundaries, and happiness leads to victory. You never see a sad person, or usually don't see a sad person that could win. We have to be happy. And at times like these, like this one, we must summon strength from our global Jewish family and lean on each other for support. Look at the crowd of over 1,000 people. We're here to support each other. We're here to strengthen each other. And when one part of our family is suffering, everyone is suffering. Our family is under attack, and it is our responsibility to stand by them in every way we can. And if I could leave you with a brief message today, among the millions of words that are swirling through our minds and social media, wherever it may be, I want to leave you with one message. It may seem counterintuitive, but if the recent tragedy in our homeland has you second-guessing the wisdom of wearing your Star of David pendant around your neck, or if you're considering participating less in Jewish life at Shabbat or whatever it may be, remember the following. Never once in history, and I repeat, never once in history, not a single time, has hiding our Judaism worked in our favor and brought us safety. The exact opposite is true. Only by being proud Jews, by building our Jewish community, by engaging, participating, and bringing others to do the same, can we hope to defeat the menace of terrorism and hatred. We, me, and you, each one of you in this crowd, can make a difference. Take your pendant and wear proudly. Take your kippah and wear proudly. And display them with pride. And if someone asks you, what are you doing? What is that? Or they try to say anything that some of the scumbags said before, you say, I love being Jewish. You're a proud Jew. Put on tefillin. When you put on tefillin, it displays and it gives fear in the eyes of our enemies. It instills fear in our enemies. When you light Shabbat candles, you add more light to the world. Show up. Don't shy away. Don't be scared. Show up. And may God Almighty protect our brothers and sisters. Many of them are your age. Many of them at the music festival, if I may say, not even one was over 30. They're your age. You each are thinking what your plans in the future are going to be. You each have a vision of how you want your life to be. There's over 1,000 lives, young lives stolen from us. And it's up to us to make their lives live on. Show up. And always love being Jewish. So everyone together, let's say together, I love being Jewish on the count of three. One, two, three.
I love being Jewish.
Everyone scream together, I'm Yisrael Chai, on the count of three. One, two, three.
I'm Yisrael Chai.
And the main thing which I left for last, honestly, because I forgot. I want to thank Ethan Fine, Rabbi Sue, and every single one of you for joining our event. They coordinated this event and made this happen. And most importantly, I want to take this opportunity to thank those that care, support, and protect us. Thank you, IUPD, for being and taking our backs. God bless Israel, and God bless America.
I want to introduce you to somebody who is incredibly special to me. For the last 3 years, we've taken a group of students, non-Jewish students, to Israel with us each summer in August. And one person, many people, many students that I met on that trip were incredible, and those trips were incredibly special. But I want to introduce you to somebody now who said to me on the trip as we were going through Israel, he kept saying to me, Rabbi Sue, don't worry, I've got your back. And he has done that and had our backs ever since we've been back on campus. And I think he represents many others here who also have our backs. So I want to introduce you to somebody incredibly special to me and very important to me, Joshua Kruda.
Hello, everybody. This past weekend, Israel faced an unparalleled tragedy, the most devastating terror attack in its history. The shockwaves of this catastrophe reach well beyond its borders, touching our very souls here and now. I stand before you not as an Israeli or a Jewish individual, but as a student leader here on campus, profoundly shaken by the terrorism and the violence that took place. My interest in foreign relations and with multiple direct experiences in Israel, like Rabbi Sue said, especially through leadership initiatives like the Maccabee Task Force with Hillel, have given me a genuine appreciation of the resilience, the unity, and the strength of Israeli and Jewish peoples. So today, more than ever, I am honored to call myself an ally. Being an ally transcends mere passive acknowledgement or silent endorsement and embodies a fervent dedication to comprehending, championing, and elevating those who face injustice. To be an ally is to recognize the inherent value in every individual. Believing that in our shared human tapestry, we are all reflections of the divine, crafted in the image of Hashem. It is about cultivating a deep understanding and mustering the courage to to relentlessly advocate for peace, justice, and truth, even when it feels out of reach. Such commitment demands unwavering support, not just during moments of joy and celebration, but crucially when confronted with profound sorrow and adversity like we are facing today. The events of this weekend have driven home a painful reality. These attacks target not only Israel and the Jewish community, but challenge the foundation of Israel's right to peace and sovereignty as a state. As we gather tonight, the purpose is clear. We mourn the hundreds of innocent lives lost, both Israeli and non-Israeli. And we stand united, firmly opposing the violence and hatred propagated by groups like Hamas, Hezbollah, Iran, and any entity seeking to destabilize this region with terror. With our collective presence tonight, we send a clear and powerful message to the world. Despite the looming terror, our spirit is unwavering and our resolve unbreakable for peace. So to my Jewish brothers and sisters, you are not alone. You have allies. This pain is shared and your resilience is recognized. And to the allies here tonight that may not be Jewish, your presence and your support are integral, reinforcing the global call for unity and peace. 100%. But here in the U.S., we're battling misinformation, bias, and prejudice on what's happening in the Middle East. Let's be clear, we won't back down. Our guiding principles in this fight remain peace, truth, justice, and steadfast solidarity. As we remember the fallen, the kidnapped, and the injured, we underscore the shared values that unite us all, love, peace, and unity. Let our united stance today serve as both a beacon of hope and a testament to our collective resolve. In solidarity with Israel and with everyone seeking peace, I thank you. The people of Israel live! Yeah.
Telling the truth is crazy in a world full of lies. As if somebody loves you, I wanna fight. But my hands have broken one so many times. So I use my voice, I'll be so fucking rude. First they always win, but I know I lose. And I sing a song that we just starts. But I set a wall to another heart. And I wanna cry, I wanna love to love. In Israel, I am a thief.
It's 30 in the morning on a Saturday on a holiday. Israel was surprised by an unprecedented coordinated attack by Hamas terrorists that have invaded Israel by land, by air, and by Hamas terrorists have taken over cities, towns, and kibbutzim in the south of the country. They have taken men, women, and children out of their beds into Gaza. It should not be presented in any other way by international media than what it is, an assault on Israel. Hamas doctrine is a murderous doctrine that is intended to do one thing and one thing only. Murder as many Jews as they possibly can and wipe Israel off the face of the earth. Men, women, and children, and the elderly, kidnapped by Hamas into Gaza. Over 200 Israelis slaughtered at homes, civilians, and this is what's happening right now.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me in the back? Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. My name is Rachel Applefield, and I am the president of IU Hello. Yay! Wow. This weekend has been awful, terrifying, and heartbreaking. No matter how educated you are or how much you know about the conflict, I hope you understand that these are innocent lives being murdered, tortured, raped, and taken away. My heart goes out to each and every individual that has been impacted. Israel is so significant in my life. As a Jewish American, I've experienced many different acts and forms of anti-Semitism. The state of Israel is somewhere I always knew I would feel safe in the world. Many people believe that I would feel safe in the U.S. However, there has been a rise of anti-Semitism, and it is terrifying to see it take its shape. From the burning of mezuzahs to finding swastikas on this campus, anti-Semitism exists at our school. The only reason why I felt some comfort was knowing that we will always have Israel as a safe place for Jewish people, and that we will always accept, and it will always accept us if, God forbid, another Holocaust ever happened. But seeing the mass murdering of Israelis and Jewish people has completely shattered my world. I do not feel safe now. I'm terrified. I pray and pray that this purgatory will come to an end. If you support anything, I wish it is peace. I'm so grateful for the Jewish Hoosier community for coming together. Thank you so much. And Am Yisrael Chai.
I now want to introduce somebody who's been on our campus since I was a student. He taught when I was a student here at IU. He's the reason that we have a Jewish studies program on this campus that we can be proud of. And he is also now has founded and is the director of the Institute for the Study of Contemporary Anti-Semitism and a foremost scholar in the entire world on the Holocaust. I want to introduce you to Alvin Rosenfeld, Dr. Alvin Woo! Rosenfeld.
My gosh, when I look across, I usually teach classes of 25 students, and there must be 1,000 of you. Does my voice carry with the microphone?
Yes.
Can you hear me? I'll try my best to make it louder. It's wonderful to see everyone here. As Rabbi Sue just mentioned, 13 years ago, I did create Indiana University's Institute for the Study of Contemporary Anti-Semitism. There's only one other institute of its kind at an American university, that's at Yale. And at a time of rising anti-Semitism, there's a lot for us to get to know. With respect to what we're doing here tonight, what I want to emphasize is the following. There are two wars going on right now. One of them is the military campaign now against Hamas, after Hamas's massacre of so many Jews in Israel. That's 6,000 miles away from here. Some of you have family and friends involved in fighting that war. As it happens, my own youngest grandson, who's your age, he graduated high school only a year ago, is in the Israeli army trained as a medic, and he's based in the Negev close to Gaza, tending a lot of wounded and injured people. The war that falls to us to fight, however, is not that war, it's a propaganda war. And take for granted that Israel is going to be set upon here in this country, you are going to be set upon here in this country as well. The most aggressive form of anti-Semitism today is anti-Zionist anti-Semitism. It visits campuses across the country. Right now, as we speak, there have been demonstrations against Israel at Harvard, Yale, and other campuses. I've been at IU for a long, long time. For the most part, I'm proud of the fact that ours has been a welcoming campus, a hospitable campus, a Jew-friendly campus. We want to make sure it stays that way. God willing, it will, but you may have a role to play also if things turn against us here, as they might. And one of the things you need to know is who it is that Israel is right now fighting in the Middle East. Who is Hamas? And you owe it to yourselves to spend 5 minutes, not more, Googling the Hamas charter. You'll learn that Hamas is an offshoot of something called the Muslim Brotherhood. The war they're fighting is not a war that's political and territorial in nature. First and foremost, it's a religious war. It's a holy war. It's a jihad. And people who fight jihad wars see themselves as martyrs for a cause that they're willing to sacrifice themselves for. It's not possible to make peace with jihadists. Israel's going to have to defeat them very soundly. That's not going to be easy. It's not going to be quick, but it is going to happen. And as it happens, there's going to be more and more and more pressure in this country, including on campuses, to defend Israel. The fact that there are so many of you here tonight gives me personally a great deal of confidence that that's going to happen. But prepare yourselves by learning a bit about Hamas. They stand really for something that one cannot reconcile oneself to. They're a very, very dangerous, bloodthirsty group. You all owe it to yourselves to learn about the Hamas Charter and do what you'll need to do if the question is put to you, why can't Israel make peace with these people? The Palestinian people deserve peace. There's no question about it. But the Palestinian people are not represented only by Hamas. There are others as well. God willing, one day there will be a possibility of making peace, but that's not going to be soon. What is going to be soon is going to be tough. It's going to be borne by people 6,000 miles away from us, but it's also going to be borne by me and by you as well, as that propaganda war comes here as well. Do your best to learn. Do your best to stand up for Israel. We all know what year this is in the secular calendar, 2023. What year is it on the Jewish calendar?
5784.
There you go. What does that tell you? It tells you the Jews have been around for a long, long time. We're a resilient people. We'll remain a resilient people. It's not always easy, but it's going to fall to you, to me, and others like us to make sure that we're still here in this generation, the next one, and the following. Blessings on you all for coming, and let's hope we'll get through this sooner rather than later without too much more bloodshed. Thank you all for coming.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Maddie Berkeley. I'm the president of Chabad here at Indiana University, and I'm honored to be speaking to you today. We stand before you as strong, proud Jewish women, and I feel so many things, but don't quite know the right words to say. But seeing over 1,000 people here today absolutely warms my heart, because this is community, this is family, this is love, and this is why I love being Jewish. I never could have imagined that I would wake up on a Saturday morning to see women, children, innocent civilians raped, murdered, kidnapped, and paraded through the street. This is against every religion, every culture, and every part of a functioning society. Our people are suffering. A single loss of Jewish life is felt by all Jews around the world. You may have watched the news the last 3 days. You may have seen things on your social media. All of them indicate that Jewish people are at a war with terrorism. So let me be very clear. The Jewish people, my people, our people, are at war. Terrorism doesn't end with the Jewish people, but it begins with them. Never again is today. I stand here even more proud to be Jewish than yesterday, and my promise to every anti-Semite out there is I will continue to be a proud Jew every single day of my life. Woo! Not just for me or everyone here, but and not for only the Jews at IU, but for Jews all around the world. The Jews that came before me, my family,
and for my future children and my children's children. So what do? We're here, and our brothers, sisters, parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, friends, and more are across the world fighting for their lives and our right to self-determination as Jews in our holy land. We do more mitzvahs. We hang mezuzahs. We attend Shabbat dinners. We proudly wear our star. We educate our peers in a respectful way and continue being a strong Jewish community. I'm Yisrael Chai, everybody. Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Abby Rose, and I'm the Vice President of Chabad. Thank you all so much for coming tonight. Like many of you, I am in shock over what is happening in Israel over the past few days. I have still not fully comprehended the atrocities being committed against the innocent civilians in Israel as the terrorists of Hamas continue to rape and murder our brothers and sisters. But seeing this many people come together on a Monday night is bringing me hope. I have the honor of serving as a leader in the Jewish community here at IU, but by gathering tonight, you have all stepped into your own leadership roles as present allies of Israel. While my friends in Israel have been living a nightmare, they have texted me multiple times today thanking us for holding a gathering in honor of them. So thank you all for showing up and not backing down for them. This is not a time to focus on the politics that have taken over for years on end. This is a time to come together and mourn for those we have lost and pray for those who are fighting for their lives. We must remain united within our Jewish community to get through this dark time. And if anyone here is not Jewish, we thank you for coming and supporting your friends. It truly means the world to us. I love being Jewish today and every day. This love is not going anywhere, and I hope we can all continue to stand strong against the terrorists and fight for our people. Am Yisrael Chai.
My name is Kunde Ikeli, and I'm teaching here at IU. I've been studying anti-Semitism for quite some time, but when I had to stand in front of my class this morning and tell them that the war in Israel by Hamas terrorists resulted in the worst killing of Jewish civilians since the Holocaust, I choked. This is unprecedented in the post-Second World War order. What we're witnessing is the murderous anti-Semitism on a massive scale. Jews are targeted indiscriminately again. In 1967, a few months after the Six-Day War, Martin Luther King Jr. reportedly said in response to some anti-Zionist remarks, "When people criticize Zionists, they mean Jews. You're talking anti-Semitism." Hamas has murdered, maimed, and abducted hundreds of Israeli civilians and soldiers during an unprovoked attack. This terrorist organization, backed by Iran, attacks Israelis because its goal is to destroy the state of Israel, the Jewish state, as Hamas officially have repeatedly said, also to kill Jews as Jews. And any justification for Hamas must be condemned for what it is, a justification for the indiscriminate murder of Jews. Now is the time to stand in solidarity with Israel and the Jewish people. And it warms my heart that I see so many of you here out tonight. Please join me in saying, "Am Yisrael Chai, long live the people of Israel."
Am Yisrael. Am Yisrael Chai.
Thank you so much. Give a round of applause. Yes.
Hi, everybody. My name is Suzanne, and I'm down here from the ADL. I am heartbroken. I am angry And if you are heartbroken and angry too, that is very understandable. But do not lose hope. Look around. You are not alone. Thank you for coming out tonight, and to all of our allies, thank you for coming out tonight. This brings me hope. And I want you all to have hope and understanding that the Jewish community and the organizations that protect us are organized in a way that we have never been organized before. I come from the ADL. I bring greetings and love from the Jewish Community Relations Council and the Jewish Federation of Greater Indianapolis. We fight anti-Semites and anti-Semitism for a living. We are working very hard to keep you safe. And today, we sent a letter to President Witten because Ethan called it. We know when conflicts rise in the Middle East that anti-Semitism under the guise of anti-Zionism rises on college campuses. We sent a letter to your leaders today explaining to them how to implement the White House plan to combat anti-Semitism. And if that level of fighting anti-Semitism sounds kind of boring to you, our Center on Extremism is actively monitoring and disrupting plans by extremists to violently attack Jews. You are not alone. There are many people working extremely hard to protect you so that you can stand here proud and in community. We are not Jews with shaky knees. Even when we are heartbroken, especially when we are heartbroken, please remember every regime that has ever tried to end us is now history.
Yeah.
We will outlive them. Say it with me. Am Yisrael Chai.
Am Yisrael Chai.
Can you hear me in the back? Yeah. My name is Sophie Shaffron, and I'm a junior here at IU, and I'm also the president of Hoosiers for Israel. Woo! Woo! I am in a state of shock about what is happening to the country I love and the people I love. As the granddaughter of a Holocaust survivor who lost 70 plus members of their family, and as the sister of two incredibly brave Israel Defense Force soldiers, I cannot help but feel the pain of the generational suffering that my people face. Everyone that came here tonight has made a difference. Even if you do not think you have, let me be the first to tell you, I will feel better walking away today than I have felt since I got a call from my mom at 1:13 a.m. on Saturday. Every one of you here reminds me of the strength that not only IU has, but the strength that the Jewish community has, as well as the friends of the Jewish community. We will get through this. We will survive. The Jewish people have survived thousands of years of persecution, and each time we have come out stronger. I pray for each and every person affected by the war occurring in Israel. Whether you are on the front lines or donating a few dollars to a trusted organization, thank you for helping. I saw a post today, and I feel that it will resonate with many of us and what we are feeling here today. When you ask your Jewish friends, are you okay? Physically, for many of us, I guess we are. Okay. But no, none of us are okay. Not a single Israeli or diaspora Jew. This is our family, and these are our people. Whether we know them personally or not, this brutality impacts us all deep in the core of who we are and our Jewish community. Religious or secular, it does not matter. We are all Jews, and many of us Israelis too. It'll take a long time before any of us are okay again. Please keep your Jewish friends close. We all need as much support as we can get. Yes. Woo!
Want to say thank you so much to everyone who's spoken tonight. And I also want to say thank you again so much to all the students who've helped to organize this tonight. We wouldn't be doing this without Ethan Fine, without Sophie Shaffron, and without many, many more students who've been behind the scenes helping to make this happen. Before we go, we have a couple more prayers that we'd like to offer. First of all, there's a Jewish prayer called Misha Beirach. May the one who blessed our parents, our ancestors, bless all of us who are in need of healing. This prayer we're going to be reciting for everyone in Israel who's in need of healing, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. But I think we can recite it for Jews all over the world, because all of us are in such deep emotional and some of us physical and psychological pain right now. So in a minute, we're going to be led in Misha Beirach, the prayer for healing for all of us. Before we do that, I just wanted to announce that both at Hillel tomorrow starting at 10:30 a.m. and Wednesday starting at 3:30 p.m., we will have somebody from CAPS there to speak with us. And also, we're open all day tomorrow, the next day. We have food. We're there to talk with you, to gather. Please feel free to join us. And then also at the Chabad House, they're open and welcome you to please go there for support as well. We're here as a Jewish community united to support you both at Hillel and at Chabad. Woo! And now I want to invite, and also I want to let you know that on November the 13th, I know it's a little bit of ways away, Neil Lazarus, who's an incredible speaker about Israel, will be speaking. Please watch for more details.
Thank you, Rabbi Sarah.
And now I invite Zivi, Alana, and Molly to lead us in Misha Beirach. Please join with them.
Before we begin, if your candle is out and you feel comfortable putting your arms around each other, this is the prayer that I would invite you to do so. Thank you. And please join along if you know the Hebrew.
May the source of strength who blessed the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing and let us say, bless those in need of healing with refuah shlema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say,
So one or two more quick things. First, echoing what Sue and everyone said, thank you for being here from the bottom of each and every one of our hearts. Before we wrap up for this evening, I'd just like to say that there is such a power in our numbers. But post on social media these photos and videos that you're taking. Show your friends that you're here and show your family that you're here. Because the people of Israel need to see all of us. They need to see all of us. And so now we're going to say the prayer for the state of Israel in Hebrew, and we're going to say Misha Beirach for the Chayilei Tzahal, the members of the IDF. Avinu Shebashamayim, Tzu Yisrael v'Golo, Barach et Medinat Yisrael, Reshit Tzmichat Geulatenu, Hagen Alea ve'Avat Chasecha, Ufros Alea Sukkat Shlomecha, Ushlach Orcha ve'Mitcha Le'Asheha, Sareha ve'Yotzeha, V'Tagnen Be'Tzah Tova Mifanecha, Chazek et Yidei Meginei Eretz Kodshenu, ונחילם אל הנה ישועה, ואתר ניצחון תיאטרם, ונתת שלום בארץ, ושמחת עולם לישביה, ונאמר אמן.
אמן.
And now Mishabach for the IDF.
How you doing? My name's Itai. I just want to say, you know, my best friend in the entire world is serving in the army. He's up by Lebanon, and so I just want to do a prayer for him and all the other people fighting to protect us.
Mishabach avoteinu Avraham, Yitzchak v'Yaakov, hu yivarech et chayalei tzeva hagana l'Yisrael, ha'omdim al mishmar arzenu v'arei Eloheinu, migvul ha'Lebanon v'ad midbar Mitzrayim v'min ha'yam ha'gadol, ad lavo ha'arava ba'yabasha, ba'avir u'bayam. Yiten Adonai et אויבים הקיימים עלינו נגפים לפניהם. הקדוש ברוך הוא ישמור ויציר את חיירנו מכל צרה וצוקה ומכל נגע ומחלה, וישלח ברכה והצלחה בכל מעשה ידיהם. ידבר שענים תחתם ויראתם בכתר ישועה ובכתרת ניצחון וכהן בהם. הכתוב, כי אדוני אלוהיכם הולכם אליכם אליכם לכם עם אויביהם להושיע אתכם ונאמר אמן.
We have many people, as we've said, who've been brutally murdered and have lost their lives over the last 3 days. There's a prayer in Judaism called the Mourner's Kaddish. That prayer actually praises life because we know that our lives will continue even though we will deeply miss every single person who's been brutally murdered over the last few days. If you can see, the prayer is up here if you want to join with me in reciting the Mourner's Kaddish. And it will be followed by Hatikva, which is the hope. That is the Israeli national anthem. The Mourner's Kaddish, please join with me. Yit gadal v'yikadash shemei rabba v'yalma divra chirutei v'yamlich malchutei בחיי חון, ביומי חון, ובחיי דקול בי ישראל. בגלל ובזמן קריב אמרו אמן. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם ועלמי עלמיה. יתפרק וישתבק ויתפואר ויתרומם ויתנשא. ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתעלל שמי דקודשה בריחו. לעולם עם כל ברכתה ושירתה, תושפכתה ונחמתה, דם ירם בעלמה ואמרו אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה, וחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. And now, if we can all join together in Hatikva, the Israeli national anthem. Again, Hatikva means the hope, because in spite of everything, we know that Israel will live and we will continue to have hope for a better world. Please join us.
Nefesh Yehudi Homia Udfate Mizrach Kadima Adi Etzion Sofia
Thank you everyone for coming. Thank you for showing your support.
Never.
never, ever, ever let those who hate us beat us. I'm Yisrael Chai, wishing the best for everyone, and remember, we are all here for each other. Have a good night, have a great week, and thank you all again.
I'm Yisrael Chai.